Welcome to Design for Children. This is Parallel Session 1A. I'm Bhavna and I'll be the host for this session. The track of the session is School for Children with Focus on Play and Learn from IST 1400 to 1530 hours. So let me introduce Professor Rupa. Professor Rupa Agarwal is trained as an architect from School of New Delhi and an industrial designer from IDC IIT Bombay. She completed her PhD from IDC School of Design. Her training on one hand has given her grounding in the traditional principles of design and confidence to foray into exciting new areas of design on the other. Her research interests are design theory, design methodology, design ontology, sustainability, and design history. She's a professor at National Institute of Fashion Technology, Mumbai. She has been in the core committee of visionizing multidisciplinary master's program based on the design research. She has held several senior positions at NIF, like chairperson of Fashion Communication Department and Design Space Department. Also, as a campus academic coordinator of the NIF Mumbai campus. She is currently the head of the craft cluster activities for all the 16 campuses of NIF. A very warm welcome to Professor Rupa Agarwal. So I will now request Professor Rupa Agarwal to initiate this session. Thank you.
Thank you, Bhavna. So as you all know, without further ado, I think I will start. As you all know that you have 15 minutes to present and 5 minutes for discussion. I think in the interest of all of us that we keep to the time. And I think it's you know, much more fun to have questions and people react to your papers rather than make the presentation very long. So the first paper is titled Exploring the Semantic Way of Teaching English Alphabet to the Children of Indian Vernacular Medium Schools. And this will be presented by Abhay Verma and Abhijit Padun from Central Institute of Technology, Kokrajhar, Assam. Can we have the presenters, please?
Thank you, Professor Rupa, for the introduction. Now I'll go ahead and share my screen. So would like to start by a very interesting quote by Saul Bass, which says, "Design is thinking made visual." So hello, everyone. My name is Abhay Verma, and I am a multimedia communication design student at Central Institute of Technology, Kokrajhar, Assam, India. Today, I will be talking about my paper, which is titled to Exploring the Semantic Way of Teaching English Alphabet to the Children of Indian Vernacular Medium Schools. Starting off, how it took place and how this paper, how this project came to life, it started when in 2018, I decided to move from Uttar Pradesh state, my home state, to Assam for pursuing my design education at Central Institute of Technology, which is situated in the BTAD region of Assam. Now, what are BTAD regions is Bodoland Territorial Autonomous Districts. These are the some districts which have been allocated by the government of India to a specific tribe, which is known as Bodo tribe. It targets to uplift this tribe. So Assam has a lot of different other tribes, which include Ahom, Boro, Garo, and so on and so forth, many more, which was the most interesting part for me to go and study different cultures there. Now, this project is based on the Bodo community of Northeast India. And let me give you a couple of facts about Bodo community. So Bodo is a tribe of Assam, which alone has more than 1.2 lakh speakers. They have their own language system. Devanagari script is used to write the official documents, and even unofficially they use English or maybe Devanagari, to write their documents. And Bodo language has multiple dialects throughout different districts, but the fundamentally it is same. Now, when I moved to the college, a variety in scripts, dialects, language was observed. One thing which I observed that since a lot of students in my institute were from Assam itself,
they were having slight communication issues amongst each other. And since I'm a Hindi speaker originally from Uttar Pradesh, and I was a little bit confused that why are they having communication issues, because I haven't experienced anything like that before. But then I came to know that there are multiple languages and dialects and so on and so forth. But they were having poor English proficiency skills as well. So I wanted to dig deeper into this zone, that why this is happening. And in order to explain the project, I'll take you through the 5-step process. I've divided this whole presentation into 5 parts, which is starting off with the problem towards the approaches, existing approaches, and solution and adaptation and future aspects. Okay. So starting off with the problem was these children were not able to, were very fluent in their English speaking skills because they were coming from Indian vernacular medium schools, and the conventional teaching methodology which has been followed to teach English alphabets in the primary level children was not good enough, and not just even in rural schools of India. But even in most of the schools globally, the standard teaching methodology for teaching English alphabet system, which is the base of English, is taught. And for example, it looks something like this, like all of us have studied throughout our childhood with this process, that there will be a word letter, and then that letter will be associated with some kind of word, and then there will be a visual representation of the word in any different formats, can be a realistic picture or an illustrative diagram. And the simplest one is a line drawing, which is the most easier for the primary grade children to understand. Now, there were also the other existing approaches to teach English alphabet system, which if we go on to on YouTube or YouTube different channels and different communities, they try to teach personifying some object or presenting a letter with some funny sounds. But the problem was these approaches didn't solve the problem properly, and it was kind of ineffective because A, rural schools were with suitable technology, and interactive facilities are not available in most of the schools, and kids find it very difficult to process such diverse visual information. What was happening at this point of time in the current teaching methodology is the remembering of the whole concept was given more priority, that how you can mug up the alphabet system rather than understanding. And with the unsubstantial foundation, it is almost impossible for these children to further enhance, develop and practice this skill in their daily day-to-day operations. What we wanted to make a model of learning is where understanding is given much more priority than remembering of the concept. By understanding within this context, what I mean is that association with physical objects, primitive shapes, and by adapting to a certain teaching and a learning process. So what were our approaches? Before showing you our approaches, I'd like to show what is actually semantic typography upon which this whole project is based on. In the semantic typography, there is a visual representation within the word itself. So C for clock, so the visual representation of a clock will be embedded in the word clock itself. With our first approach, we went ahead and we embedded an alphabet within the image. So let's say C for comb. So within the structure of a comb, there will be a C. And within the structure of an ape, there will be an A formation. Now, the second approach was like taking the last approach and then presenting, like teaching in the class along with the physical object, just like this. Teachers can teach with the comb and teach them the process. But of course, it is not feasible in all of the cases. A couple of things can be brought to the class. Of course, not all of these things can be brought to the class. And the initial approaches were pretty interesting, but did not solve the problem entirely. A, because everything cannot be brought to the class, and B, children were unfamiliar with most of the objects such as ape, flamingo, or something like that, which they cannot relate or remember, and which they haven't seen before. In the existing, from trying in the first approaches, what we came to know that what was happening, that English alphabet system was being taught by using English words. And English words were further coupled with the foreign objects. Now we went ahead, we had the model, we had the basic idea that what was happening and how these things can be sorted out. So we went ahead for the exploration in the nearby town. And we found out, we started collecting different objects which were locally made, locally produced, or if they were not locally produced, they were at least available in the region where their school is based, so that children see these things into their day-to-day life and they are already familiar with these things. So we can take these objects and then further proceed with our research. We started developing the sketches with the things which we had collected, and we started figuring out that how we can find out certain letter forms in the visual representation of the collected objects. We went ahead for the initial survey, but children were following, like the very first time when we did the survey, the rural school children were not able to recall the English alphabet system very properly, or the associated words. They were having a couple of problems. And what we needed to do, we went ahead and we tweaked this model slightly. Now we are going to teach English alphabet by using Bodo words and then associating them with the local objects or the objects with which the children are familiar with. Okay, moving towards a solution. Now we made a semantic expression within which the alphabet or a letter form is embedded. So let's say A for Anjor. So for setting up the context, A for apple is being taught, but A for Anjor. Anjor means rat in their own tribal language, in their own rural language. And these are the steps in which the teacher can teach and the students can learn that you can make an A and then you can make out a Anjor or the rat out of it. Now, with the final survey, since I'm not a native speaker of this language, I went ahead with a couple of volunteers and a few friends from my college and went ahead and taught them this new system. They showed a very overwhelming response. They were not just able to recall, they were excited, A, because they have never seen something like something in their native language to be taught. And these are the examples of the drawing sheets from the children which we had collected. Now they were able to grasp this new English alphabet teaching methodology, of course, but there were a couple of surprises as well. We were stunned in seeing that in the first attempt, learning and teaching attempt itself, the children were not able to just learn what we had taught them, but they were also able to create their own semantic expression. So let's say B for Bere, what we taught them, that use B to make a body of a bee and then attach a wings to it. One student, what he did, he made a body first and then he used B to make the wings. The other student started implementing the emotical faces inside a structure of a O. So these are a couple of more examples which we had made of the semantic expressions. Now, what are the adaptation of this whole methodology which we had presented, and what are the future aspects of it? I would like to invite the designers, like globally, to keep it limited to this one Bodo language which I had just discussed about. This methodology can be expanded further for many different Indian languages and scripts, and countless number of students would be very grateful to learn by not using the existing methodology, which they find very difficult. But they will be learning it in the most easiest and the most interesting format possible. This methodology is effortless adaptation of teaching methodology, enhanced learning experience. This will give a unified, structured teaching methodology for kids of varying levels. Communication was increased amongst teachers and students, which we had inquired upon talking with the teachers that they had taught the students for a couple of days by using this methodology. So it was very interesting for the teachers as well. Flexible teaching methodology allowed teachers and students to become comfortable with the overall learning and teaching curve. So finally, thank you, not just from my side, from all of the volunteers, from all of the students who were able to learn this. And finally, I would like to thank my all-time mentor and guide for this project, and also the co-author for this project, Assistant Professor Abhijit Padun, children and the staff of Alarayan School, and of course, the organizing committee of IDC IIT Bombay for organizing this huge event and giving me a platform to speak.
Please go ahead. Feel free to ask any questions. Hope you found it interesting. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Abhay. That was very interesting. I was reading the paper also, and there's a little more details in that. So I urge everybody to read the paper as well. I was just checking the chat, Bhavna. Is the chat where the questions are going to come?
Yeah, it's the chat.
Okay. I don't see any now. So I have some of my own. Somewhere in the paper, you have mentioned about phonetic conversion, which you didn't mention in your presentation. I was curious how you chose phonetics for the selection of the objects, probably, and then went on to the semantic association. Would you like to elaborate on that?
Sure, sir. So, like, that was one of the first steps which we went ahead during the time of working, and I gave a little hint of it during the presentation. So, let's say A for apple, and if you're going to translate in the Devanagari language, or just a direct phonetic conversion will be like apple written in Devanagari. We didn't want it to do that because it will still remain apple itself. It will still remain an English word. What we did, we collected a lot of different Bodo words, their own words from their tribal languages, starting from A, which means A. So from the Shabd A, we collected a lot of different words, like Anjur is one of them. And we did this process for A, B. B means Ba, and C means Sa. So we collected a list of with a huge lot of words. And then we converted them into how it will be written in English. So A for Anjur, which is Anjur in Hindi, Shabd. And it will be written as A-N-J-O-R. So we converted them and we chose the first letter. So Anjur A, Bere B, B. And how we can use that first letter form to develop the semantic expression further.
All right. Thank you. That was wonderful. So, now I have some more questions, and some of them echo what I feel. There's one which Anisha says, great presentation, Abhay. Did you also try teaching them Bodo using the same method? Did you get the question?
Yeah. Also, is the method targeted towards preschool ages? And what about learning the correct structure and form of the letter? Since they have grown in their environment, they are very much familiar with the Bodo language. So in Assam, if you're going to see, Bodo is their tribal language. So this is the first language which they already know. So we don't need to teach them Bodo language. And their second language is probably Assamese, since they reside in Assam. The third language will be Hindi or English. So we don't need to teach them Bodo. I hope that answers the first question. This was based on teaching English by the aid of Bodo language, which they already know, right? Also, is the method targeted towards preschool? If yes, then what about learning the correct structure and form of the letter? Okay, I think I'm getting it sort of. What I feel like Anisha is asking that the correct structure by which she means that if it is A, so I made it curved. So what about the straight A? So in the initial stage, if you are going to teach them that how to draw A in whatsoever, like if you are going to teach the primary level children that draw a straight line and draw like this, of course, they are not going to do the same. They'll be doing something on their own. And if they will having a fundamental foundation in the upcoming classes or in the upcoming teachings, they'll be able to refine the drawing of the letter form structures, of course. So, yeah.
All right. Thank you, Abhay. I think your paper and the visuals that you showed of your interaction with the students were all you with the students. It would be nice also to see more detailed reactions from the teachers, because they are going to be very, very instrumental in delivering this entire methodology that you have developed. So probably you have already thought of that, and all the best. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much.